Gloria and Emilio Estefan just had quite the payday. The couple's Miami mansion they bought almost 3 decades ago for about $1.84 million has sold for a whopping $35 million. Located in the coveted Star Island, Gloria and Emilio got top dollar for the nearly 8,000 square foot abode, which they formerly used as a guest house. As you might have guessed, the couple has another property they still call home just down the street. Today we'll check out the gorgeous home that Gloria and Emilio just cashed out on and more. In these videos, we don't reveal any addresses, and even though I've done a house tour of my own place, please do not show up at any private residences because it's not safe for anyone. Gloria Estefan is a Cuban-American singer, songwriter, actress, and more who began her career as the lead singer in the group Miami Sound Machine. She experienced worldwide success with the song Conga back in 1985, and she's considered the Latin artist who broke down the barriers of Latin music in the international market. Gloria's husband Emilio Estefan is also a musician and a producer who's received 19 Grammy Awards over the years. He also rose to fame as a member of Miami Sound Machine alongside his wife, and he's also part of the reason Latin music experienced a crossover in the late 90s. Many famous Latin artists like his wife Gloria, Ricky Martin, J-Lo, Shakira, and more were brought to the US music stage by Emilio himself. At the time of this recording, Gloria and Emilio have amassed a net worth of about $500 million, and that doesn't even include the crazy sale of their Miami mansion. Over the years, the highly successful couple's guest house on Star Island has come up as a pricey rental more than once, but this time they finally found a buyer. Hey everyone, I'm Kara the Vampire Slayer, bringing you another exclusive house tour here on Famous Entertainment. This one, checking out the Star Island mansions of Gloria and Emilio Estefan. If you haven't already, be sure to subscribe and ring that bell for notifications because we post brand new videos daily. As always, you can follow me on Instagram to chat, and now let's get into this video. It's just been reported that Gloria and Emilio finally sold one of their coveted Miami mansions. The couple invested nearly 3 decades ago, purchasing the home in 1993 for $1.84 million. And what do you know? That investment paid off big time as they unloaded it for a whopping $35 million. In case you're bad at math like I am, reports say that's a profit of $33.16 million for the star couple. The all-white mansion is located on Miami's exclusive Star Island and sits on a corner lot spanning about 1.2 acres. The Estefans got top dollar for the nearly 8,000 square foot mansion that boasts 6 bedrooms, 10 baths, and 240 feet of sparkling waterfront. The property also has unobstructed views over to Biscayne Bay and the downtown Miami skyline. The man-made Star Island is the spot in Miami, Florida, and it's appropriately named considering all the celebrities have been known to live here. Gloria and Emilio are just a couple of them, considering Jennifer Lopez, Sean Diddy Combs, Shaquille O'Neal, and many more have all lived here or still do. There are only about 3 dozen mansions in total on Star Island, and it's rare one of these beauties comes up for sale. Even an empty lot here will be sold for over $16 million, if you could believe it. Now that's exclusive. You can see a view of the island that was developed by the Army Corps of Engineers way back in 1922, and it's only a short drive across to the mainland, so it's still considered a part of Miami Beach. If you're wondering where Gloria and Emilio will be moving to post-sale, the answer is that they're not. Apparently, this mansion was used for guests when they were visiting the couple, and at one point, Emilio's mother was living here. The Estefans still own their main house located just down the street. Gloria and Emilio listed this mansion back in 2017 for $40 million, but then took it down and relisted it for around $32 million, finally making a sale they were happy with. Anyways, let's take a look. Of course, the amazing home is in a gated community for privacy, but what else would you expect from Star Island? There's a private dock with electric boat lift on the waterfront, and the property is surrounded by tropical foliage and towering palm trees. Inside, the entire mansion has white-themed decor to match the sunshine and ocean surrounding the home, as well as the exterior, which is also a crisp white. The home was built in 1940 and upgraded plenty since, featuring hardwood and marble floors, elegant arched doorways, and open patio spaces. Gloria and Emilio's kitchen was spacious, boasting white cabinets and matching countertops, with plenty of natural light and a long island in the center for more room to cook. The large refrigerator was also covered in white to match the rest of the open kitchen. Much of the mansion had a Mediterranean style design, as we can see in the formal dining room, where there were arched top doors. One of the living rooms featured a white fireplace alongside neutral colored couches and large windows for plenty of views. Another den in the Estefan's home had more windows as well as doors to the yard and plush furnishings. Other features inside the house included a piano room, second floor loft, and a bonus private entrance. As for the bedrooms, most if not all had views of the water in addition to French doors leading out to verandas. There were also plenty of arched closets and storage space. There were also gorgeous vintage-inspired ensuite baths, one with a claw-style bathtub and large mirror next to it, this bathroom with access to the patios too. Aside from the spacious main mansion, the property boasts another separate two-story guest house at the front of the property with three bedrooms, two full baths, and a half bath. If that's not enough, the guest house even has its own spacious living room and private dining room. In another section of the main mansion, there's a separate tiled hot tub located within a classy courtyard, and there are plenty of covered walkways off of the mansion, which are all lit up so late night walks or swims are easy to do. The lush backyard has a resort style pool and spa, which has got to be the main attraction back here, but you also have the ocean just a few steps away. Other features in the sprawling backyard include a large bar area next to the pool, a summer kitchen in the gazebo, and plenty of space to entertain or dine. As I mentioned, the Estefans had Emilio's mother living in this home for quite some time, and then after she passed away, the couple rented out the guest houses as far back as 2013. When they first listed it as a rental, we can see the inside was a bit more dated and the place hadn't been upgraded yet. The entire estate was available as a furnished lease at $75,000 per month, and at one point it was up for $7,500 per night with a 3-night minimum. And in case the buyers of the estate loved the location but not the look of the home, the Estefans brought on architect Carlos Ott to design plans for a completely new, contemporary style home to build in its place. This estate could fit on the 1.2 acres and the new concept shows overlapping crescent moons from an overhead view in honor of Estefan's recording studio, Crescent Moon Studios. While we can't look inside Gloria and Emilio's neighboring main mansion, we can see from aerial views that the property is sprawling, and so is the home itself. The lot is covered in palm trees for privacy and shade, and we can see the Estefan's home is also right on the waterfront, boasting a pool and spa and a private dock. The couple purchased this home on Star Island, just a stone's throw away from the one they just sold, back in 1986 for only $600,000 and have been living there since. These days, this estate has an assessed value of over $25 million, which is crazy, but makes sense. Built in 1959, the mansion spans over 15,500 square feet of space with 6 beds and 11 baths. Not to mention the land itself spans 2 acres right on Biscayne Bay with glorious views. Now we've taken a look at the homes of Gloria and Emilio Estefan, mainly the guest mansion they just made over $33 million on, so I think that brings this house tour to an end. After seeing that beautiful Star Island mansion and all the luxury it packs in, was it worth that much money? I mean, I don't think any home is worth that much, but Star Island is the most exclusive neighborhood around after all. What was your favorite feature at the Estefan's mansion? One of the features I loved was that secret jacuzzi in the courtyard area, just because it reminds me of something from the ancient Roman times. Of course, ocean views from most of the bedrooms is also a selling point. Be sure to let me know your thoughts on Gloria and Emilio's homes down in the comments. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram, and I will see you all next time. Bye.